Good morning, YouTube. How are you guys doing today? It has been a while, but hey, today I want to talk to you guys about the craze for all the iPhone users out there. We're talking about Clubhouse today. Let's go. It is a freezing cold day. Put the mask on because we visited Tim Hortons already. All right, let me grab a seat and let's talk about Clubhouse. Anybody else have their glasses really fog up really heavily when they're wearing their masks? For those of you that don't know, Clubhouse is an iPhone-only app, in brackets, for now. There's lots of push for Android users to get access to Clubhouse as well, but it's a social platform, it's mobile only, and it's basically like little chat rooms that's voice only. That's the key, it's voice only, and I think that's the catch for a lot of people, that it is voice only. I got access last week because my man Jim Fuse, shout out to Jim Fuse, thanks for the invite. He invited me to Clubhouse. It's by invite only. When I joined, I had one invite, then I was given two invites, and so I gave those out right away because people in my Facebook group were asking for invites. And so, yeah, I jumped on yesterday for the first time as a host. So I was checking out a couple sessions as a listener, so you can just jump in as a listener and not talk, just listen. But yesterday I was invited by Caleb and Katie from Ecamm to be a host, a co-host in their room. So that was really fun. You know, we had 20, 30, 40 people, I think, you know, kind of join us throughout the hour. I think they went longer. I had to kind of dip out because I had to do another session. Voice only, talking about a specific topic, answering questions. You can bring people in from the crowd. If they raise their hand, they can click a button and they can raise their hand, and then you can promote them to be a moderator or a speaker so that they can join. And they can also share the ideas and talk and answer questions and ask questions as well. So it's a really cool platform, very new. I really respect the way that Clubhouse is building things. It's very much lean startup style. You know, if you go to their FAQs, for example, on the website, it goes to Notion pages. So they're using Notion as their FAQ, and the majority, I think, of their website. If you click on any forms, it goes to Airtable. So they're using Airtable, and so they're leveraging other platforms for now as sort of an MVP for this product, which is really, really interesting. And you know, there's a lot of people that are in the space that are very curious and really excited about Clubhouse. You know, notably, Michael Stelzner, who's the owner of Social Media Examiner, is very big on Clubhouse. He published a blog post and he talks about it on social a lot. I'll link a couple of his posts down in the description, to the point where a couple of our friends in the industry actually asked him if he was an investor, and he said no, not an investor. He wishes he was, but he's just very excited about Clubhouse and the potential for Clubhouse. The sun is right in my face. It's beautiful. I miss the sun. Actually, it was snowing yesterday, so there's still some snow on the ground, but I do miss the sun. I miss the heat. Anyways, it's really cold though. It's freezing, actually. Anyways, back to Clubhouse. I'm curious with Clubhouse, what's gonna happen to it? You know, this is probably the first of a few videos over time where I'll update you sort of on what's my experience with Clubhouse. Would love to hear what your thoughts are. Would like to actually hear what your thoughts are on the future of Clubhouse, whether it might get acquired, whether other platforms, you know, bite their style and, you know, take, you know, build their own audio only platforms. I know Twitter has already, you know, done something similar. I'm curious what your thoughts are on it. The experience as a host is really fun. It's like having your own little live radio talk show almost, and the engagement is really high. I encourage you to go check it out. I'm hearing a lot of people that like it, that don't like it, that think it's a fad, think it's here to stay, you know, think that there is a space for it in, you know, the overall social media ecosphere. You know, I'm never one to kind of really take other people's word for it without trying out the platform itself and sort of, you know, writing off a platform without actually, you know, putting some time and effort to see if it's worth it to invest your time into building a following and an audience on a platform. I think there is a place for Clubhouse. You know, with the session that I ran yesterday on YouTube strategies, it was really well received. And, you know, I think I will do some more over the Christmas break and do some more sessions and host some more sessions. I'll definitely tune in to a few more sessions for sure as a listener and just an active listener participant. But I definitely want to host more sessions. So, yeah, let me know what you think of Clubhouse. Let me know if you're on it. Let me know. I don't have any more invites, unfortunately. If I do, I'll share it in my Facebook group. So if you're there, then maybe you'll see it if you need. Also, if you do need invites, there are some people inside my Facebook group that still have some invites if you want to get into Clubhouse. So if you want to check it out for yourself. But there's big names that are on it as well. You know, Gary V's on it. Terrell Owens, if you're a football fan, is on it. You know, big marketers are on it. So naturally, entrepreneurs and marketers are quick adopters of new platforms. So there's a lot of marketers on it, but I see in the future, you know, other creators in other niches jumping on it as well. You know, it's a great way overall to just engage with your audience. You know, right now we're not able to travel and do summits and conferences and in-person things. So this is a really good way for creators and entrepreneurs and brands to really engage with their audience in this format. Time will tell if it will stand the test of time and, you know, people will engage. I think there needs to be some monetization models built in so that creators can, you know, obviously, you know, make money through Clubhouse. There's obviously money to be made in other ways. Some of my friends, there's some snow falling from the roof here, so hopefully it doesn't land on the camera. I think we're good for a bit. I think there's other ways to monetize Clubhouse if you're building an audience there. You know, there's ways to drive people to your website, to your landing pages, to, you know, your coaching calls. You know, I know that friends of mine, like Diana Gladney, who jumped on Clubhouse really early, like real early, she's already gained some new clients and already booked some coaching calls and already had people approach her for brand deals. So I think that there's definitely ways to use it to grow your business, growing your audience in general, and just engaging with your community in this fashion. I think it's exciting. I'm gonna give it a fair shot and a fair chance before I write it off. And who knows, you know, I'll do an update again once, you know, there's some substantial changes and updates to share with you guys on my experience with Clubhouse. But for the meantime, I think if you're an iPhone user, check it out. If you could get your hands on an invite code to Clubhouse, check it out. Check out a couple sessions, see what you think, and, you know, not just write it off. You know, not just say like, eh, it's kind of a fad. Check it out. And people that I thought would write off Clubhouse as sort of a fad are really digging it. So yeah, definitely check it out. If you can, host a couple sessions as well, and then promote it and share it on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, and invite people to your Clubhouse session. It's a cool way for your fans and followers and subscribers to just engage with you in that format. So that's my thoughts on Clubhouse for now. I'll definitely share any updates that I have for you guys as time goes on with Clubhouse. If you are on Clubhouse, then let's definitely connect. I'll put my, you know, my Clubhouse username in the description and my links and stuff, and let's connect on there. Yeah, hopefully you guys are enjoying Vlogmas. I have been sleeping on Vlogmas. This is my, you know, my first Vlogmas video in probably a week, but it's just been crazy with things that TubeBuddy and with Ben, and we are going on break. This is technically the last day before we shut down until January. It's been a lot of things to cram into a little amount of time, but very excited for 2021. This won't be my last video of the year on my YouTube channel, but you know, just wanted to let you guys know I have been sleeping on Vlogmas, and so proud to see though all the people that are crushing Vlogmas daily. Doc Rock, Alessio, Lamwell, you know, everyone in the Let's Get Live Facebook group, you guys have been doing awesome things. If you're new, we just connected, we just met, feel free to subscribe so you can see all my upcoming videos. Head over to my Facebook group as well. That's kind of where I hang out outside of here, and also on Instagram. Send me a message, post a comment. Love connecting. And if there's anything that we can do to collaborate in 2021, definitely gonna be big on collaborations in 2021. So connect with me and let's bounce some ideas on how we can collab together. All right, take care guys. Pew, pew, pew. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.